I'm glad to have you join me for devotions for today, Thursday, July 30th, 2020. Let's begin with prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Glorious Lord, your generosity waters the world with goodness, and you cover creation with abundance. Awaken in us a hunger for the food that satisfies both body and spirit. And with this food, fill all the starving world through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. If you saw a devotion that I did before from this spot, you know where I am. If not, that's okay. Let me give you the 360 tour like this. Mural of Jesus with the people gathered around, and we will go around, and we're in the food pantry, the other side of the food pantry. So here's the area where I was when I did the video a couple days ago. And just a dividing wall and a little reception area over here, and some coffee, bulletin board, the desk where you check in during regular times, and the parking lot, of course. And we're fortunate because of a lot of help. We were able to put in a door, an exterior door that goes right to the parking lot here. Let me get centered back where I was with the light a little bit better, with Jesus and the people gathered around. The idea behind having this particular mural in the food pantry is that Jesus did have the people all gathered together, or actually the people came to him near the water, and there are not anywhere near as many people here as we would imagine when Jesus fed the 5,000. That's what I'm working up to. I didn't say that, but that's what I'm working up to. So this could be any time that Jesus gathered people together and they listened to him. But we like to think that maybe this is right before he fed them with the fishes and the loaves. Let's hear part of that reading from Matthew. It will be the gospel reading this Sunday. Here's your assignment right away. Read all of Matthew 14, chapter 14. At least the first 21 verses. And you're going to see why when I just read a couple verses to you right now. So this is Matthew 14, verses 13, 14, and 15. When Jesus heard what had happened, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the towns. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and healed their sick. As evening approached, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place and it's already getting late. Send the crowds away so that they can go to the villages and buy themselves some food." I'm stopping there, but that's not the end of the reading. You know what happens from that, don't you? And maybe if you don't, you can go ahead and read the rest of the verses. But read the verses that come before. So I'll just go ahead and tell you, as I already did, the following verses, carrying on from where I read, goes on to tell the story of Jesus feeding 5,000 men plus women and children, right? Because they don't have anything to eat. And the disciples say, they're getting hungry, send them back to the villages so they can go get something to eat, so they can buy themselves some food, right? And the other part that I want to especially talk about here is verse 13, where I started reading. It says, when Jesus heard what had happened, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. What happened? What happened? He heard about John the Baptist. He heard about how John the Baptist had been killed. He had been beheaded by Herod. Want to hear that story? Read the 12 verses before. Remember that John the Baptist would have been Jesus' relative, probably a cousin or second cousin, and he definitely a second cousin or farther out, but a relative, a family member. And they both knew that the ministry and mission that they were about was very similar. John the Baptist pointing to Jesus, and of course Jesus pointing the way for all of us to himself and to God. So this hit Jesus very hard. He heard about what happened, and he just wanted to get away from everybody and not have people asking for him to do things. But what happened? He went off by himself, and the people heard about it, and he went in the boat, but they found a way and went around on the land, and they found him. And what happened then? Does it say he said, leave me alone and let me have a few days' grief? Let me be by myself for a little while and process this? No, it's good that he went out for that time alone. And yet when he saw them, he had compassion on them. He healed their sick. And then the story continues with what we then know will become the feeding of the 5,000. That's Jesus. Compassionate and loving, no matter what. So, if you'd like to hear more about that, please join us in worship Sunday morning, 9:15 here and at church. And if you cannot be here with us, then you can watch the video, which should be on anytime Sunday afternoon, Sunday late morning or afternoon, as soon as we can get it on YouTube and Facebook. Let's go ahead and pray together. We bring you our prayers, dear Lord, and we thank you for we pray for our concerns for this world and for our nation. We pray for those infected with COVID-19 and the uncertainty that they face. We pray for the concerns of the communities in which we live. We lift our faith communities up to you in prayer. We pray for our friends and our families, for those dealing with difficulty and those celebrating with joy. We pray for Cash, Ariane, Marilyn P., Bev and Phil, Reverend Donald White, Anthony, Trudy, Jane and David, Arlene F., Susie, Andy, John, the families of Ralph and Catherine. Bless us this day and help us in the following ways. And as you have taught us, we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. Deliver us from evil, and deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.